everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Ruth and this is my first YouTube video. Pause for me. I just went to this coffee shop across the street from my condo. It's called Le Beau, I think. This is really good. This is an iced latte with oat milk, no sugar, and it's so good. I mean, if you're used to like Tim Hortons coffee, then this is gonna be like 10 times better for you guys. Okay, so today we are doing a get to know me tag so you guys can get to know me. And I'm just gonna do some light makeup, just a little bit of makeup. I actually started on my eyebrows. I don't know why and I didn't press play, but it's okay. Okay, so the first question is, how old are you? I am 23 years old. I am turning 24 on April 24th, so in a couple months I will have a birthday vlog for you guys. I'm gonna do like a little get together at home with just some of my close friends, so nothing too big, nothing too special. It is my champagne birthday, so I definitely want to, like, you know, have the people I care about around me and just celebrate and have fun. But yeah. Next question, where do you live? I live in Toronto, Canada, so I'm Canadian. yeah, I've lived here all my life. I came here when I was 3 years old from Ethiopia, which is the next question. What is your background? I'm Ethiopian. I moved here with my mom. My dad like came, was here a couple years before us, and then he brought us over, but I came here when I was 3 and a half, so literally 20 years I've been here. So I pretty much just lived here all my life. You know, I don't know anything, but I don't know anything about my life before Canada. Like, I don't remember my childhood back home at all. I mean, there's pictures and videos and stuff, but like, there's no memory. So like, I don't remember my grandmother who passed away a couple years after we moved here, so that's kind of sad, but yeah. Next question, what is on your bucket list? If we're talking about, it doesn't specify, but if we're talking about like travel list, then I actually have a separate list of places I want to travel. I'm just gonna read that out to you guys. Okay, so the first place I've always wanted to go to is Turkey. Turkey is so cool. Like, you can do so much shopping for cheap. Like, I've been to the United Arab Emirates. I've been to Dubai. So I've been in that part of the world. So it's definitely cool. I just love, like, their culture. It's just like completely different from, you know, what we're used to here. I mean, Turkey is completely different from Dubai. Like, it's not the same thing, but you know, it is an Arab country at the end of the day, so it's like the same vibe. But yeah, I've always wanted to go to Turkey, and it's my mom's dream as well. She's always wanted to go to Turkey, so you know, if I could take her there, that would be like something accomplished for me. You never know, we might go next year, but I mean, nothing's set in stone, right? So, next place is Mauritius. Mauritius? I think that's how you say it. I don't even know how you say it, guys. But I've seen so many videos on Mauritius. It's so beautiful. It's so, like, tropical. That is a really pretty destination spot. I think a lot of people go there for, like, honeymoons. I think that's a popular honeymoon destination. I don't think that's not where I would go for my honeymoon, but I definitely would go there for a trip. Next place is Sri Lanka. My co-worker is from Sri Lanka, and she was showing me pictures and stuff, and it's so beautiful. I feel like a lot of people don't really think of that part of the world. Like, I don't think people are like, oh, I want to go to Sri Lanka for vacation, but It's really beautiful. It's so tropical, and it's like a different vibe from like a Caribbean vacation. It's obviously it's a little bit more expensive when it comes to the flights, but it's definitely like cool spot to go to. China has been on my list for a while. China's actually really cool. Like the history, just like the landscape and everything is just honestly, it's just such a cool place. It's like, yeah, I've been to China. I don't know anyone that's been to China, so I would love to be the first person out of like my friend group or whatever to go to China. Thailand, another one that's been on my list for a while. I think Thailand is on everybody's list. I think Thailand is a very famous, very popular destination spot because, I mean, it's beautiful, it's cheap, and there's just so much you can do in Thailand. Like, everything is cheap, so you can really do anything you want. Even if you're going for like 10 days, there's so many things you can do, like go from island to island. So that's definitely one of my dream vacation spots. And I would do like a big group trip there because you can get like a villa for $2,000 for like 10 people, which is insane. But yeah, another spot. I'm sorry guys, I'm just doing, is it just me? Like, nose contour always gets me. I can never properly like contour my nose. It always just comes out like wonky. But I try not to do the most when it comes to my nose contour. I just try to do something like light. But yeah. Next place is Saint Lucia. Saint Lucia is so magical. It is so beautiful. I was seeing videos of Mountain Jade, I think that's what it's called. If I can find a video, I'll insert it or pictures or something in it right now, but Sri Lanka would definitely be like my honeymoon destination. It is beautiful. I'm not sure like how the prices are. It might be a little expensive on the expensive side, but it's my damn honeymoon. I don't care. My husband better be paying for that. No questions asked. But next, Costa Rica is actually a new addition to my list. I've seen a few videos and pictures on social media, on YouTube. Costa Rica is so cool. It's definitely like an adventurous place, I would say. I mean, I haven't really looked into it too much, but looks like a cool spot. I think my nose contour looks a little crazy, guys, but I'm gonna fix it. Brazil, another one that's been on my list for a while. Brazil is so cool. I don't want to say beautiful. It is beautiful, but I'm like, if I went, I would go just like to Rio, like just the capital. Like, I wouldn't really explore too much because you just never know. But it's just a really cool destination spot, and it's been on my list for a while, so I would definitely go with friends. Qatar, I think that's a new spot on my a new destination on my list as well. Qatar just looks so cool. I've seen so many vlogs on Qatar Airway, like people going on Qatar Airway, and it's honestly like just as good as Emirates. So I think Qatar would be like a cool place. Just to say I've been there, really. I don't really know what they have there. I think this might be like another Dubai. I'm not really sure what they have, but I definitely would want to go just to say I've been to Qatar. But I don't really know too much about the spot. And that's all I have there. But I have like a separate list of cities in the US that I've always wanted to go. So I put Chicago, Miami, Orlando, Atlanta, Houston, LA, San Fran, Austin, Las Vegas, and San Diego. I think those are just some of the spots I really want to go to. I haven't really thought about it. I've been to New York, that's why it's not on my list. I went a couple months ago with one of my girlfriends, so I've crossed New York off the list, but New York would be, I would go back. Honestly, if I had the chance to go back to New York, I definitely would. I would not do the same things. Like, I wouldn't go to, like, Times Square. I've been through it. I've lived through it. Thank you, Times Square. It was chaotic, and I don't think I'll ever go back. But we didn't even get to go to Little Italy, which is so sad. But this time, we're going to go. So, yeah. Next question. What is your favorite recent memory? So, my favorite recent memory, I would say, is my trip to Punta Cana. I went end of May 2023, so it was like in the beginning part of my summer, but it was towards the end, so summer was, honestly, I had a really good summer. Like, I think I had one of the best summers of my life. That was my first trip I went alone, like, without family, just friends. It was my first Caribbean tropical trip, too, so I had a blast. Like, we made memories, we made friends. Like, that will be a memory engraved. I have so many pictures in my room. Like, I don't want to go into too much detail because I don't really have any footage to show you guys and stuff. Like, I didn't vlog. But if I had the chance to vlog, I definitely will. I'm definitely going to have a trip this year, so stay tuned for that vlog. I will vlog that for you guys. Like, I want to, you know, do a travel vlog. That'd be so cool. Next question. Did you go to college? Yes, I went to college. I went to Humber College, North Campus, and Lakeshore Campus. If you're from Ontario, then you know what I'm talking about. But yeah, I did the paralegal degree program, so it was a four-year program. And yeah, I'm not a paralegal at the moment. I don't think that's the route for me at the moment. I got my schooling, I got my everything, but being a paralegal, that's just not my plan right now. I'm a legal assistant at a law firm downtown Toronto, so I think I'm just gonna focus on that for a little bit. I have other plans for myself that don't involve being a paralegal, so yeah. How long was your longest relationship? So my longest relationship was, technically, it was 2 years, year and a half, I think. Yeah, we broke up end of 2022. We were not bad terms or anything. It was pretty mutual. I think there was just a lot of factors on my end. I don't know about him because we really didn't discuss it like that, and that's one issue. I'll admit my my communication skills are a little bit bad in relationships, but I'm working on that. We're working on it, so there's nothing I can do about it. Because it's a past relationship, you know? Like, there's no hard feelings on my end. I don't know about him, but we never ended it off on bad terms, so it's fine. But yeah, we were together for 2 years. That was my first relationship, so you know what? I learned a lot from it. I learned a lot. Like, I know what type of person I am in relationships. I know what I want out of my partner, so yeah, you know, you live and you learn. That's all you gotta do. Have you ever had a nickname, and what is it? Yes, I have two nicknames, actually. So my first nickname is Salam, and that's just like my Ethiopian nickname. Like, my family calls me that. Some of my friends, some of my Habesha friends. Mostly, like, my family and, like, Habesha people call me Salam. It's just, I've been called that since birth. Like, my grandfather gave me that name, so yeah. My second nickname is Ruthie. My old co-workers at my job used to call me Ruthie. I don't know. Someone started and everybody just started calling me Ruthie, so everybody calls me Ruthie, like, when I see them and stuff. But they're the only ones that call me that. No one else. Like, none of my friends call me that. Like, it's just them. But you know what? It's cute. It's special. So, I like it. Next question. Do you have any pets? Yes, I do. I have a cat. She's right over there. I'm not going to touch her because she's in a mood. She's been in a mood since yesterday, so I'm just going to leave her alone. She is a ragdoll. I'm going to put in a video of her. She's a ragdoll breed. Her name is Tilly, and she is a year... She's going to turn 2 in July. So, she's a big girl now. She's not too young. She's not too young, so... She's like looking at my stuff. I can't even pay attention to right now. Okay. Do you prefer the city or the country? I prefer the city, to be honest. I'm a city girl. I've lived in a city for all my life. So I'm just used to just like the craziness and everything. But you know what? Like, once I have a kid, and once I have, like, a family and everything, I think I would settle down into the suburbs. Not, like, the countryside, but, like, the suburbs. I would be fine with that. I would raise a family in the suburbs. Yeah. Guys, I've had this palette for so long. It's the Huda Beauty Rich Glow Obsession Mini Face Palette. I don't like wearing a highlighter. I just like wear it sometimes, like on my nose, but like I don't really wear highlighter like that. Like, I don't know, it's just something about highlighter. Okay, I need to fix this nose contour, it's bothering me. But yeah, city girl, always been a city girl, always will be one. What type of content will you be uploading? So, I think I'm gonna stick to lifestyle videos, vlogging, health and fitness, because I just started my fitness journey a couple weeks ago. So, I think I'm gonna focus on those three types of videos for you guys. I'm definitely gonna have a gym vlog soon. I've just been a little... I need to fix some things, that we'll say that. But, yeah. It'll be those things for you guys. I mean, I'll do like the occasional like fashion, beauty, skincare and stuff, but I think I'm just gonna focus on those. Are you a full-time YouTuber? If not, where are you working right now? So I think I previously mentioned this in the video, but I am a legal assistant at a law firm in downtown Toronto, so I don't do YouTube full-time. I'm just starting out, it's my first ever video, so obviously I'm not doing it full-time, but I definitely would love to make YouTube a part of my life. I think doing YouTube was on my vision board for the year, so I'm actually happy I'm taking the initiative and doing it, because you know how it goes with vision boards and all that. But yeah, if you could describe yourself with any three adjectives, what would they be? It's like one of those questions, like if your friends had to describe you in three words, what would it be? I would say confident, loyal, I would say independent, because I'm an only child. I'm very, very independent when it comes to, you know, just everything I've done, honestly, like, besides my parents, it's from my own experience. It's from my own thoughts, if you know what I mean. Like, I get advice from my friends and stuff, but I've never had, like, a sibling to be like, oh, do this, like, don't do that. Like, every decision I've made in my life is honestly from my own thing, if you know what I mean. I'm not really the best at explaining things, but yeah. Yeah, so confident, loyal, and independent. Do you have any phobias? I You know what? I don't like insects. Like, I hate insects. I hate butterflies. Like, butterflies disgust me. I know what you guys are thinking, like, butterflies. But honestly, have you seen a butterfly up close? Do you know how nasty they look? They're so... Ugh. I just hate insects, like, altogether. I hate insects. I hate reptiles of any kind. Just everything, to be honest. I don't know if she's in the frame, but she's, like, about to go to sleep. Oh! Mimi's! Okay, I'm gonna leave you alone. What are your top three priorities in life? I would say to be genuinely happy with my life. I don't want to be content. I want to be happy. Like, I want to be, I want to look 20 years from now. I want to be happy with my life. I want to be happy with where I am in life, as in career-wise, family, just everything. Happiness. To be successful. I definitely, whatever success means to everyone, I think being successful, as in if it's the amount of money, being married or whatever, like, everybody has their own description of what success means to them. And I think for me, it means, I think it means, like, having some type of job or business or something that I always can not do, but I think for me, it's business wise. Like, I don't want to be that person that has a 9-to-5. So I think when it comes to being successful, I would want to have a successful business, whatever that is. I think having a successful business is very important for me. I'm still, like, in the beginning processes of, like, deciding what I want to do. So whatever it is, I want to be successful. And if that means having a business, making a lot of money, whatever it is, I want to be successful in life. And the third priority in life, honestly, this is a hard question. Happiness, success. I think having a family is a priority for me as well. I would definitely love to have, like, you know, like, the typical little family, with kids, husband, mom, and dad are together, obviously. Just have that, like, perfect little life. I think that's really important for me. Yeah. I would say those three things. This question's got me thinking. But yeah. Do you have any siblings? No. I think I said this as well in the earlier video. I don't have any siblings. I'm an only child. So, yeah. I think I have only child syndrome. Like, I'm not a brat, but I'm definitely very independent. Like, I know what I want. Like, I'm very self-sufficient. I've never had to rely on anybody for anything except for my parents, obviously. So, yeah. I think I'm gonna end it off on that. This video might be a little bit long. I don't really like long YouTube videos, so I'm just gonna keep it cute and short for you guys. But yeah, if you are still here, please like, comment, and subscribe, and that will mean a lot to me. I appreciate everybody that has watched my video up until now. So I want to say thank you to everyone. And stay tuned for my videos to come. So thank you, guys.